This video is a bit of an award ceremony, or recognition ceremony. In my review of Himote House, I mentioned that I thoroughly enjoyed the show, and that the episodes kind of kept me guessing. Now, if you're watching this video, it means you're one of the few other people on the planet who actually watched Himote House, so I get to share and celebrate some of my favorite moments from the show. For me, it started with the first episode. It really sets Himote House up as a straightforward, random screwball comedy. But importantly, when the psychic powers are revealed at the end, it does so by building ridiculous power onto ridiculous power so quickly, it really punches up the humor of the premise. Add to that, most of the characters' blasé whatever attitude towards these powers, and it really comes across as a constructed bit of humor, not just a scene that ticks off a few boxes of traditional anime wackiness. I'll admit, the first few episodes after that, with their focus on dating, while funny, aren't particularly wacky. But episode 4, the baseball episode, takes a simple premise, people trying to figure out a set of rules, and it drives it so far into absurdity, I couldn't help but be amused. Their powers actually assist with the comedy here too, and just enough time has passed since the introduction of those powers that their use here feels like a nice little surprise, and as before, it punches everything up and making it just even more absurd. Episode 6 was where I began to realize this show had much subtler humor than I'd anticipated. The episodes all presented like a standard anime dramatic episode, where one of the characters feels like nobody loves her and she's being shunned, only to discover it was all a ruse for a surprise. I could see the pattern unfurling a mile away, and chuckled at how well the show was following the pattern. But by the time the episode was over, I honestly couldn't tell if this was actually a dramatic episode or a perfect parody of one. I mean, this is a random screwball comedy. Doing a single dramatic episode halfway through the run with no more drama before or after seems unlikely to be straight drama. So, which is it? That's subtlety. Followed by episode 7, The Yuri Game of Life, which only reinforced my impression of the show's relative subtlety. This episode has so much fun with stereotypical Yuri storylines, even driving home the idea that every plot point so demoralizes the characters that they lose a turn. Yep. And the episode continues to elaborate this and go further, even going so far as to comment on the state of gay marriage rights in Japan. Wow. Episode 9 again showcases the show's subtler humor by putting the characters in a strange, completely unexplained situation, which is only revealed at the end of the episode, at which point all their behaviors make total sense. It invites you to watch the episode again and pick up on all the clues, which is a very rare statement for random screwball comedy anime series. Now, the final episode probably won't be as funny for those without exposure to Japanese talk shows. For those not familiar, these are ubiquitous on Japanese TV in the evenings. Guests sit down on a stage and talk to one or two hosts, and often watch clips live with the audience. They're cheap, they're completely formulaic, and this episode sends them up by actually saying that. So, Himote House isn't just a show that's trying to be funny, it's actually, in a fun way, criticizing pop culture. Now, is Himote House a deep, complex show? I don't think so. But it does try harder than a lot of other random screwball comedies. And for that, it deserves a little recognition. And I hope that this video helps.